Good morning, cadets. Today let us discuss about second application of Gauss law, that is finding the electric field due to uniformly charged infinite plane sheet of charge. Think that there is a infinite plane sheet of charge, very huge plane sheet of charge, infinitely extended, and it is uniformly charged. Uniformly charged with, let us say, positive charge density. Positive charge density, and you know the charge density in this case is defined as charge per unit area. Charge per unit area, and this is called surface charge density. Surface charge density. Charge per unit area. We are considering such a infinitely extended huge plane sheet which is uniformly charged. We want to find out electric field due to this plane sheet of charge at a particular point. Let us say at this perpendicular distance we want to find out electric field. So I have taken part of this infinitely charged, uniformly charged infinite plane sheet like this, and the charge density here is denoted by sigma. I want to find out electric field at a point, let us say P, at a distance, let us say R, at a distance R. So again we go by the method of applying Gauss law. So what I do here is I construct a cylindrical surface which will enclose this particular part of the plane sheet, and I will extend this cylinder on the other side also, because this is a continuous cylinder from left end to right end which will be enclosing this part of the charged sheet. Let us say this part of the charge sheet is of area A. It means this cylindrical box, let us say, which we have chosen, is enclosing the front part of the sheet as well as the back part of the sheet. It is not only charged on one surface, it is charged on both surfaces. It is uniformly charged on both sides of the sheet, front sheet, front surface as well as back surface. So we are constructing a cylinder which will enclose this part of the sheet, and then we apply Gauss law. Same thing I have drawn in a small diagram here so that I can write the derivation and in this particular part. Okay. So the procedure is to construct Gaussian surface. Construct Gaussian surface. Here I am constructing Gaussian cylinder. Gaussian cylinder, and then apply Gauss law. Consider uniformly charged infinite plane sheet with charge density sigma. So here the charge density, as I mentioned, is charge per unit area. Charge per unit area, uniformly charged. Now particularly I am taking positive charge so that it can be generalized even for negative charge. Now as we discussed earlier, the electric field at this point will be directed away from the sheet, perpendicular to the sheet. If you consider part of these sheets symmetrically above and below, the electric field, as we mentioned earlier, the normal components of electric field cancel each other. Only horizontal components add up to give you electric field only in perpendicular direction. So electric field is perpendicular to the plane sheet. Electric field E is perpendicular to the charged sheet, plane sheet of charge. And if it is a positive charge density, it will be away from the charge, perpendicular to the sheet, and it is directed away from the charge sheet. If it is a negative charge density, if it is negative charge density, then electric field will be towards the charge sheet. Okay, if it is minus sigma, if the sheet is totally distributed with negative charge density, then the electric field is towards the sheet. Okay. Now, to find electric field at P, then what we do? Construct a Gaussian cylinder to enclose a small area let us take this small area as A, to enclose small area A on both sides, because this uniformly charged sheet is charged on both sides, okay, with a total charge density sigma, small area A, to enclose a small area on both sides, so that this cylindrical box is not only found in the front portion, it is also found at the back portion. So if you look at the back portion, the electric field is again pointed perpendicular to the charge sheet and it is directed away. Now, since it is enclosing this particular area, we need to calculate what is the charge enclosed so that we can apply Gauss law. Okay. Now, applying Gauss law. That is flux. Total flux enclosed is equal to 1 by epsilon naught times the charge enclosed. Now we can calculate the flux. The flux enclosed here is enclosed due to the flux linking with this cylinder. The flux linking with the cylinder can be calculated for three surfaces. One, that is the front circular surface, second one the back circular surface, and the third one the cylindrical surface. So if you look at the first part, the circular surface, the area vector you see is outward normal, and this area vector, if you call it as n cap, it is directed in the same direction as that of electric field E. The same way here also, if you draw a normal to this circular face, the normal drawn is perpendicular outward, and the electric field is also outward. So again, in this case also, electric field and area vector both are in the same direction, and the magnitude of area is same as magnitude of area enclosed here. So here also it is the same area A. Now if you draw perpendicular, that is normal to the cylindrical surface, the normal to the cylindrical surface, if you look at it, you see it is perpendicular to the cylindrical surface, and electric field here, you see the electric field is always perpendicular to the sheet. So the angle between the normal here and the electric field is 90 degree. So the flux linking with the cylindrical surface, the flux linking with the curved surface of the cylinder is zero, because the angle between area vector and the electric field vector is 90 degree. So I can calculate now total flux. Before that, what is the charge enclosed? Charge enclosed Q can be calculated from charge density. Here the charge enclosed Q is within that area A, so Q is equal to sigma A, right? Because sigma is the charge per unit area. So the charge enclosed by this cylinder is charge enclosed within this small area A. Therefore sigma is equal to Q by A. When sigma is equal to Q by A, Q is equal to sigma A. So that can be substituted in the left hand side. Now we can calculate what is total flux enclosed by the Gaussian surface. Total flux enclosed by the Gaussian surface. So I will call it as total flux as phi 1, that is flux linking with the first circular surface, phi 2, that is flux linking with second circular surface, phi 3 is the flux linking with the curved surface, flux linking with curved surface, right? Phi 1 plus phi 2 plus phi 3 is equal to sigma A upon epsilon naught. So now I can calculate what is phi 1, what is phi 2, what is phi 3, right? So here it is again E dot A, directly I will write E dot A, because area here is A, therefore I can write E dot A. Similarly, in the second case also, it is E dot A, because the area through which the flux is leaving out is again A, plus E dot A in this case becomes E A cos 90. So cos 90 becomes 0, because the angle between area vector and the electric field vector is 90 degree. Therefore the flux linking with the curved surface of the cylinder is 0, is equal to sigma A upon epsilon naught. Now as I said, the angle between area vector and the electric field vector is 0, therefore EA cos 0, EA cos 0 becomes EA, plus here also for the second phase you can see again the area vector and the electric field vector are in the same direction, so EA cos 0 again becomes EA, cos 0 is 1, so EA equal to sigma A upon epsilon naught. So 2 times EA is equal to, therefore I can write 2 times EA is equal to sigma A upon epsilon naught. So A cancels, when A cancels you are left with electric field E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught 2 times, sigma upon 2 times epsilon naught. So this becomes the electric field. Now what is the direction of electric field? Electric field direction is along this direction of the point, away from the point, perpendicular distance. So I can take it as R unit vector, where unit vector R is of magnitude 1 and it shows the direction that is pointing away. So we can write here, therefore electric field E due to infinitely extended plane sheet of uniform charge density sigma is given by E is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught r cap, where r cap is nothing but 1, and it is just to show the direction. It is directed away, pointing away from the plane sheet. Plane sheet of charge. So if this sigma is negative, if the sheet is totally charged with negative charge density, then it will be pointing towards, it is perpendicular to the plane sheet of charge, no doubt, but it is pointing towards the plane sheet of charge. Okay. This is how we derive the equation. One important thing you remember here, that electric field is independent of distance. E is independent of, magnitude of E is independent of distance r. Independent of distance r, because magnitude of E, if you write, it is just E equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. So electric field is just directly proportional to charge density. More the charge density, more is the strength of electric field. Less the charge density, less is the strength of electric field. So if it is a huge sheet of charge, you can remember, when there is a huge sheet which is uniformly charged with some charge density sigma, then electric field is independent of distance, means electric field is uniform, electric field is constant. So this is a very important thing to remember. It is just depending on the value of sigma. Okay. Now this is the case. Now if there are two sheets of charges, one is positively charged sheet, another one is negatively charged sheet, then how will be the total electric field? This is very interesting. Let us see that case, and we will solve one problem based on that. I think it is quite clear by applying Gauss law, the problem of finding the field due to uniformly charged infinite plane sheet becomes simple. Now let us look at this interesting case. Electric field, to find the electric field due to two parallelly placed uniformly charged plane sheets, with one charged with plus sigma, another one charged with minus sigma. Let us say that I am just drawing. This is representing one sheet perpendicular to this board, so that you will be looking as if it is just a single line. Suppose this is charged with plus sigma, positive charge density. There is another one parallelly placed with negative charge density, right? So this is positively charged and this is negatively charged, same with negative charge density. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, I have approximately drawn with 9 plus sign to represent same amount of negative charge. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, same amount of charge density, but here it is negative charge density. In the first case it is positive charge density. Two charged sheets, infinitely large charged sheets, placed parallel to each other. Then how to find out electric field outside the positive charged sheet? Electric field outside the negatively charged sheet. Electric field inside the negatively inside the space between the parallelly placed charge sheets, right? Now let us consider, there is one point here where we want to find out electric field. The electric field due to positive charge density is pointing perpendicular, right? This is what I am going to call it as E plus, because electric field is independent of distance and electric field is pointing away due to positive charge density, but negative charge density is also there. So the electric field is independent of the distance, and electric field is, in the case of negative charge density, it is acting towards the second charge plate, so it becomes E minus. Now look at it. So electric field in the first region plus sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, and electric field due to negative charge density minus sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. When you add it, the net electric field in the first region becomes 0. Similarly here also, if you take this one as the point, let us say this point is Q, and electric field due to negative charge density is acting towards the negatively charged plate. This I will call it as E minus. Electric field due to positive charge density is again away from the sheet, so this becomes same magnitude, sigma upon 2 epsilon naught acting away. So net electric field becomes sigma upon 2 epsilon naught minus sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. So again the net field here becomes 0 in the first region, and in the second region the electric field becomes 0. Now interesting thing is the interior region, right? So I will write here in the first and second region, first and second region E plus, magnitude of E plus is equal to magnitude of E minus is equal to sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, right? That's how we have found out previously by applying Gauss law. But net electric field E becomes, since they are in exact opposite direction, they cancel each other. E plus minus E minus, E plus minus E minus, because they are equal in magnitude, exactly opposite direction. So it becomes sigma upon 2 epsilon naught minus sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. So net electric field is equal to 0. This is the case in the first and second region, right? Now in the third region, in the interior, that is third region, let us say that this is the point where we would like to find out electric field, net electric field. Net electric field due to this point is independent of the distance and is acting away from the positive charge density. This becomes E plus, given by sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. And electric field due to this negative charge density, interestingly, it is also acting in the same direction, E minus, in the same direction. So net electric field get added here. The net electric field gets added, E plus gets added with E minus. So sigma upon 2 epsilon naught plus sigma upon 2 epsilon naught, it becomes sigma upon epsilon naught. That is interesting thing. So in the interior region, net E is equal to E plus plus E minus, E plus plus E minus, since they are acting in the same direction. So it becomes sigma upon 2 epsilon naught plus sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. Thus it becomes 2 times sigma upon 2 epsilon naught. 2 times sigma upon 2 epsilon naught becomes 2 cancels. You are left with only sigma upon epsilon naught, only sigma upon epsilon naught. So what is the direction here? The direction is from the positively charged plate to negatively charged plate, and thus in the interior region the electric field is of value sigma upon epsilon naught, and it is independent of the distance. Therefore it is taking constant value and it is directed from positively charged plate to negatively charged plate. Thus it produces uniform electric field between two parallelly placed uniformly charged sheets with one positively charged and another negatively charged sheets. Okay, thus we get E equal to sigma upon epsilon naught n cap. So I can show this is direction of n cap, just to show the direction. Which is uniform field directed from positive charge density, positive charged plus charge sheet to negatively charged sheet. Negatively charged sheet. Thus we get uniform electric field in the third region, which is given by sigma upon epsilon naught, which is it is represented by parallel field lines. The parallel field lines represent electric field is uniform. That is how we get when we have two parallelly placed charge sheets, one with positive charge density, another with same negative charge density, electric field outside the plates, electric field outside the plates in this region and in this region electric field is zero. Only there is non-zero electric field existing between the two plates, in the space between two plates, and that electric field is uniform electric field, which is given by sigma upon epsilon naught. This concept we are going to use when we start discussing about capacitors. A capacitor, a parallel plate capacitor, is a device in which you will find two parallelly placed charged conductors with some space in between them. So we get uniform electric field between those two parallelly placed charged sheets when it is fully charged. Electric field is uniform, and outside the charged sheets electric field is zero. So this is interesting. Based on this we can solve one numerical problem. Look at this simple problem. Two large thin metal sheets are parallel and close to each other. On the inner faces the plates have surface charge densities of opposite signs. Suppose these are the two thin large sheets closely spaced, kept parallel to each other, one with plus sigma, another one with minus sigma. Sigma value is given. What is the electric field in the outer region of first plate? Suppose this is first plate, positive charge plate is first one, negative charge plate is second one. What is the electric field in this first region? What is the electric field in the outer region of second plate? What is the value of electric field here? And what is the electric field between the plates? What is the electric field between the plates? So from the case that we have discussed, electric field in the outer regions of the first plate and second plate, electric field in the outer regions is zero. There is only non-zero electric field existing between the two plates, as we have found out. So that non-zero electric field between the two plates, you can very easily calculate using E is equal to sigma upon epsilon naught. Sigma upon 2 epsilon naught due to positive charge density, sigma upon 2 epsilon naught due to negative charge density, add each other to get sigma upon epsilon naught. Just substitute the value, 17 into 10 to the power of minus 22 coulombs per meter square, and substitute the value of epsilon naught, 8.85 into 10 to the power of minus 12, you will get the value of electric field in Newton per coulomb. I think you will be able to solve this. Okay, try this problem. Okay, so this is a simple problem. I think you will be able to solve. Thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.